Now, whether you want to send an email, update a spreadsheet, write a book, it doesn't really matter. Having a great keyboard is going to be the cornerstone of being productive on your iPad Pro. But the problem is, not all keyboards are made equally. Some have better features, some have better typing experiences. Well, if you're anything like me, you've probably run the gamut and you want to know what the best keyboard is. Well, you are in the right place because in today's video, I'm going to review my three favorite keyboards for the iPad Pro and let you know which one you should buy. Let's get started. What is going on, everyone? It is Mike, and welcome back to Tech 24/7 TV, where we bring you the best in unboxing and product reviews so you can make informed buying decisions. Here on this channel, we analyze the various bits and bytes that transcend technology, only to find their way into your pocket. So if you like product review videos just like this one, make sure you are subscribed with notifications to be alerted when that content drops. Now, there are a lot of great keyboards on the market today for the iPad Pro, and I think I've probably seen a majority of them, if not all of them. Now, we're going to focus on three specifically, and the three that we're going to focus on are really the three, my three favorites. It's going to be one, the Inateck KB02010, quite a name. Second is going to be the Brydge Pro, and the third is going to be the Apple Smart Folio keyboard. Now, I've been using these keyboards anywhere between, you know, when November 2018, when the iPad Pro first came out, I had the Apple Smart Folio keyboard. I got the Brydge keyboard last year, maybe in April or May. And then I've had the Inateck keyboard since October or November. So I've had significant amount of time to use the keyboards, kind of find their, you know, their weak points, their strong points. And really, in today's video, we're just going to convey that to you. Now, I'm evaluating these keyboards on three different dimensions. First is going to be typing experience, which is really important. Obviously, you're buying a keyboard, you want to make sure that it does have a good typing experience. Second is going to be usability, and that usability is, you know, how usable is it, you know, not just at a desk, you know, where I think some people use their iPads, but maybe on a couch, maybe sitting in a chair. You know, how does that change and what's really the use of it? And the third is going to be total size and weight. Now, for those interested, I do go ahead and take into consideration kind of cost, but it's not a primary factor for me. I'd rather pay a little bit more money for a keyboard that gives a good experience. I'm okay with that. Two housekeeping items. First, all the timestamps are going to be pinned in the first comment below in case you want to jump around, come back to a certain section. That's going to be in the first comment below. Second, links to all the products I talk about today are going to be in the video description below, which are Amazon affiliate links, which means if you end up buying something, Amazon pays me a small commission that doesn't cost you anything. And it really just helps the channel grow by continuing to review great accessories just like these keyboards. So without further ado, let's get into the keyboards. Now, the first keyboard we're talking about is the Inateck KB02010, and I know it's a crazy name. This is $49.99 on Amazon. It actually was $39.99 when I first reviewed it. Now they've raised the price by $10 because I think it sold so well, but there's a lot of value in this keyboard in my personal opinion. So this keyboard itself is really embodies like the full protection of, you know, a keyboard case. It's got, you know, significant drop protection on the corners. It has a kickstand that flips down, giving you almost unlimited viewing angles from, I think, 30 to 160 degrees. It does have a detachable keyboard. That keyboard is backlit, and that keyboard also has a number of different function keys on there, which, you know, end up working well depending on, you know, what use cases you're trying to solve with the keyboard itself. Now, some of the other benefits of this keyboard is that it does have two different places that you can go ahead and store your Apple Pencil. One for, you know, once in transport, maybe in your bag or in your purse or whatever the case is, underneath the iPad. And the second place is going to be on top of your iPad, which will also go ahead and charge it. Now, the battery itself will last you about 6 months worth of usage, and it can be charged via micro USB, and that cable is included inside the box. Now, from a benefit perspective, the KB02010 really is the lowest cost keyboard that I've seen. In my opinion, it has really a good typing experience. The keys do have good key travel. They have a nice sound to them. It's good clickability, maybe is a word that I would think of. The keys are backlit. There are those dedicated function keys. It's $49. It does go ahead and offer you good, what I would call couchability. I think overall, this is a very good keyboard, especially when you think about the cost of the keyboard itself. When you compare it against other keyboards that have a similar kind of full body protection, like the Logitech Symfolio Pro, there's obviously a lot of value in this because at $50, you know, compared to the Logitech almost at twice the price, this offers almost the same functionality. And I think at that point, it comes down to a matter of personal preference, whether you like the typing experience on the Logitech versus the Inateck. Double the cost, you know, I can't necessarily find any significant reason why to buy the Logitech over that. Now, there are four different drawbacks to the KB02010 that I can think of. So first is going to be that wrist pad that's going to be in the front of the iPad. It doesn't come off. It can't be removed. Some people might not care about it. It might not be a big deal to you. But for me, I wish it wasn't there, or at least I could remove it. So second, the magnets that are on the keyboard to actually hold it closed while during transport tend to be not as strong as they could be. Now, I did mention this in my review, which if you haven't seen it, I'll link it above in the card maybe over here, or wherever the case is. Third is gonna be that this keyboard itself is not available for the 11-inch iPad Pro. So if you have an iPad Pro that is 11-inch, I'm sorry, you're out of luck on that one. And then the fourth is gonna be that the charge mechanism or the charging port for this is specifically gonna be micro USB. So it means that you just have to carry another cable. Again, not a deal breaker for a lot of people, but I think that is something worth noting. Now, the next keyboard we're going to talk through is going to be the Brydge Pro, which is available for the 11-inch and the 12.9-inch. Now, this is $99 and $119, respectively, on Amazon right now, which is about a $50 discount off of what it normally costs. Now, I know that Brydge is releasing the Brydge Pro Plus very soon, and in case you didn't see that video where I was hands-on at CES, I'll link that above in the card, but that is going to be, I think, $229. So there's a significant cost difference between that. Now, really the difference between those two is that it's going to have an integrated trackpad. Now, that may or may not be important to you, but make sure you're subscribed with notifications if you want to see that review when it drops, because it will be here, I think, the next week. Now, this keyboard itself, really, they have kind of a very distinct feature set. It's specifically, it's all aluminum, so it's a premium design. It is quite heavy. You know, the keyboard by itself is about a pound. So when you add that in with your iPad Pro, if you're using the 12.9-inch, it's about 2 pounds. So it's definitely thick. It does offer you a limited number of viewing angles, right? Because the way that the hinge is designed, you can go ahead and insert your iPad, and there's enough tension in the hinge to go ahead and tilt your iPad any number of different degrees. Now, some people have complained about the hinge design either scratching their iPad. Now, I've been using this for about, I think maybe since April or May of last year, and I haven't had any trouble. So I would think that those examples of either damaging the iPad are few and far between. Now, the keyboard does have a 12-month battery life, and it is using Bluetooth to go ahead and connect to and pair with your iPad. Now, unlike the Inateck, it does have a USB-C port on the keyboard to go ahead and plug into or to go ahead and charge, and you can use the same cable that came with your iPad. Now, in terms of benefits, this, again, it's got an all-aluminum design, it's got a good typing experience. In the beginning, I was having trouble, I think, when typing, where my finger would hit the, the edge of the keycap, and it wouldn't necessarily register the words I was typing. I haven't seen that lately, so I think it's maybe either it's been resolved just by me learning how to type better on the keyboard. Now, conversely, I would say that the biggest downside to getting this keyboard is that the iPad itself is not very easy to remove once you put it in there. Now, you can think of that two ways. One, the iPad's not gonna fall out from the keyboard, which, that's definitely positive. Or two, if you are someone who likes to remove your iPad from their keyboard, like I do, it's not necessarily easy, but it's not hard either. The keys are not as clickety-clack as the Inateck keyboard. They are a little bit mushier, which, again, I don't necessarily mind that, but it does have a good typing experience. Now, the third and final keyboard that we're gonna talk through today is Apple's own Smart Keyboard Folio. Now, this is available for the 11-inch and the 12.9-inch at $179 and $199, respectively. There are three distinct features on the Smart Keyboard Folio that really separate it from the other two keyboards in a good and bad way. So first is gonna be the Smart Dock Connector. Now, this is the only keyboard out of the three that uses the Smart Dock Connector, which really allows your iPad to power and pair the keyboard in just a matter of seconds. Now, there are no other keyboards that I've seen here in the US. I know there's a couple that are available in Australia, but if you know of one that is available, let me know in the comments below, because I'd really like to get my hands on another one to see it. Now, second is that this keyboard itself, it only supports kind of two viewing angles, where the other ones support really kind of unlimited. Now, there are two angles. One, I would say that is more kind of for when you're maybe typing at a desk, and one I would say that you use when you are in couch mode, or when you're right sitting on the couch, something that's a little bit more relaxed. Now, it is ultra thin. It does allow for easy on and off. So if you like to context switch from maybe writing notes to typing at a desk, this is really a good choice. Now, in terms of pros and cons, one, I really like the fact that is no pair, no fuss. I can stick my iPad in there and start typing within a matter of seconds. That is great. Second, I love the fact that I can go ahead and easily context switch and pull my iPad out and put it on the desk and start, maybe taking notes very easily. Now, the biggest pro, in my opinion, that I think many people don't talk about is that the entire keyboard is gonna be fabric sealed. So if you spill something on it, it's none of that liquid is gonna penetrate the iPad or to penetrate the keyboard and ruin it. Now, in terms of cons, what I've actually seen is that the back of the keyboard case, it almost looks like it's warped or it's been burned. Like the way that the material is textured, it has a very funny feel to it. It doesn't look good. And unfortunately, I've read that there are a number of other people online and forums that are experiencing the same issue. If you are one of those people, let me know in the comments below if you've figured out what it is. So at the end of the day, the question becomes, who should buy what keyboard? And I think that really depends on what you prioritize. Really, if you prioritize, I would say, typing, like you're doing a lot of typing, you're doing a lot of communication with it, you're spending a lot of time sitting in front of it, doing a lot of typing, really the KB02010 is going to be the keyboard for you, only because it offers, I think, such a better typing experience, in my opinion, than the other two keyboards. I mean, you're going to have the function keys, the backlit keys, the detachable keyboard. I mean, really, I think, especially at $50, in comparison to the other two keyboards that are two and four times as much almost, it's going to be way better of a choice for someone who's doing a lot of writing with their keyboard, you know, write a lot of typing. If you are someone who prioritizes, I would say maybe a higher degree of fit and finish, absolutely the Brydge Pro is going to be the keyboard for you to get at $119, especially now that it's on sale. If you can't catch it on sale, it's going to be the normal, I think, $169. Still, I would say a good deal, but not as much value at that price point. And if you are someone who really kind of prioritizes, you know, getting set up and up and going in just a matter of moments, that's where the Apple Smart Keyboard Folio is going to be the best choice for you. But I really want to know what keyboard you are using in the comments below. Let me know. I am Mike, and this is Tech 24/7. I'll catch you in the next one. When you compare it to the other two keyboards we talked about, yeah, there are three distinct features on the... God, my nose itches. Man, I am itchy as all hell. Now, some of the other benefits of this keyboard is that it has a... Now, some of the other benefits... Yeah.